This Pentagon pitch meeting is made possible by our partner, Spartan Armor. Welcome to the Pentagon, Sergeant. I hear you have an incredible new camouflage idea waiting for me. You're looking at $5 billion in research and development right here. I love the way it just pops out at you. I've always said we need an eye-catching camouflage. Did I mention this uniform is lousy with Velcro pockets all over it? I have 10% of my portfolio invested in Velcro stock. Outstanding. Every time you go to open a pocket, you'll be greeted with a loud Velcro sound. How many other camouflage patterns did this one beat out? So our lab test results showed that this camouflage was the worst option available, but we all know that science isn't an exact science. We literally and straight-faced believe that the universal camo pattern can hack your eye's detection systems, confusing it and making soldiers less visible to the enemy. That makes perfect sense if you don't think about it. But what are you gonna say to all the haters out there who will claim that this camouflage clearly makes you more visible? I'm authorized to show you a classified photo. Tell me it doesn't work now. This isn't another one of your practical jokes, right? Sir, we figured out that this will save us one literal ton of money by not having to create separate uniforms for woodland, desert, and snow environments. It's a one-size-fits-all solution. You see, instead of blending into one environment really well, it blends into all of them terribly. Wait, are you saying that it actually saves us money by cutting corners? Yes, sir, that's right. Sergeant, I can see you clearly have a bright future with us here at the Pentagon. I haven't even told you the best part yet. This uniform is all about priorities. That's why we've added a built-in pen protector right into your sleeve. We're calling it a tactical combat pen holder. This is a real thing that we made. We asked soldiers what they wanted, and we gave them this instead. Look, it even pairs perfectly with this tactical binder. But won't soldiers demand effective camouflage to protect their own lives in combat? Actually, sir, we ran some studies, and we found out that the average soldier cares way more about not having to deal with bull garrison tasks than they do with caring about their own lives. With this new uniform, you no longer have to worry about polishing black boots or sewing on rank and name tapes like you had to with the old uniforms. We believe soldiers will tolerate the trade-off of having less effective camouflage if it means that they get to spend less time doing pointless tasks. Great, so you're thinking we'll be able to release the lower enlisted early from all of their formations since they'll have all this extra time now. No, not exactly. We can't let them have that much free time. Instead, we'll have our squad leaders order them to do mindless cleaning and re-cleaning of their weapons, ensuring that the extra time isn't wasted. That logic makes me want to go hooah. So, I like how you made the pattern digital themed. Is this uniform a computer? Does it store data? What's digital about this uniform exactly, Sergeant? It does give viewers the distinctly vague impression that something futuristic is going on here, while not actually offering any additional digital powers or features whatsoever. I'm gonna assume that this camo pattern was created by an optimized computer algorithm that knows how to hack the human eye into not seeing it. You're certainly welcome to assume that, sir. Yeah, but is that how it works, though? Well, it is 2004 right now, so let's go with don't ask, don't tell on that one. I couldn't help but notice how in this Army version, you've gone and completely ripped off all of the worst parts of the Marine Corps uniform without lifting any of the effective features, like making it specific to one environment. True story, we field tested it and found that the gray and bluish colors here matched with the digital pattern make it harder to detect in one situation and one situation only, when it's viewed by night vision goggles. So what percentage of our enemy is operating with night vision goggles right now in the current year 2004? Certainly next to none, it's 2004. No one has night vision capabilities except for us right now. Sergeant, can you tell me some of the plus sides of this uniform? Why is it advantageous to stick out like a sore thumb in a combat zone? I'm glad you asked, sir. I have a PowerPoint briefing to help answer this exact question. So the pros are merchandising opportunities. You see, the civilian market will fully embrace this camo pattern because they'll see it as a non-aggressive, non-aggro military camouflage pattern. They'll create UCP leggings, UCP shorts, t-shirts, scarves. Sir, do you understand what I'm saying here? This is an Etsy seller's ultimate wet dream. I love it, but is there any way we can shoehorn this camouflage into professional sports? Sports are like the one non-political place I can still go to unwind in this year, the year 2004, and I'd like to change that forever. Of course, we're gonna have every single professional athlete wearing one of these. Will everyone eventually snap out of this mass hysteria where we've convinced ourselves that this camouflage cost-saving program ever made any sense? Roger that, sir. Around the time when Army veterans from the war in Afghanistan start actually petitioning Congress to help replace this uniform, that's when we realize that it's gonna cost us double to ourselves. And when we end up inevitably replacing the UCP by reverting to the same old woodland camo that we were using before, we will of course have learned our lesson, and we're gonna finally issue two separate uniforms for different operational environments. No, sir. We'll only issue the woodland pattern and we'll call it OCP. It sounds like you took me on a decade-long $5 billion walk around the park right back to where we were before, having accomplished very little and wasted an inordinate amount of money solving problems we ourselves created. This is a real thing that we made! You're an absolute stone-cold sociopath. I'm putting you in for a promotion to 4-star general. Ah, thank you so much. Sorry, sir, one second. I just got my Spartan body armor plates delivered. When you're wearing camouflage as useless as I am, you want to make sure that you're wearing top-of-the-line ballistic plates. Oh, is this the new contractor we're working with? No, not exactly. You see, Spartan body armor has new shooter-style plates that are lighter weight, more comfortable, and capable of stopping high-powered rifle rounds. Sir, I know you want a pair of these plates, don't you? Oh, yes, those look really nice. Wait, what's going on here? Are you selling something to me? Don't worry about any of that. These Hercules Level 4 body armor plates are manufactured by Spartan Armor right here in the good old US of A. Right out of Tucson, Arizona. Beautiful area, am I right, sir? Yeah, I was there once for an officers only pool party. No, but no. What's happening? Why am I saying these things? Is my whole life just an advertisement message designed to sell products on YouTube? So the Hercules ceramic body armor plate provides full 10 by 12 inch edge-to-edge protection for the operator. Is my wife Betty back home real? And it only weighs in at 6.9 pounds per plate. Is anything real? Each plate is rated to stop armor-piercing rifle rounds up to a 30-06 M2 AP. Who are you looking at? Who are you talking to? Click the link in the description and get your set of Spartan body armor plates today. Also, they have a 15% veterans discount. Isn't that neat, sir? Why am I wearing specialist rank? I'm supposed to be a general.